Teen violence. It's a problem just about everywhere. In California, a crowd watches a 15-year-old girl gang raped after a high school dance. Five of the six suspects are teenagers. In Florida, a 15-year-old suffers second-degree burns over 80% of his body when five teens set him on fire in a dispute involving his failure to pay them $40 for a video game. And in Chicago, this violent image captured on a cell phone camera. 16-year-old Darion Albert beaten to death by a mob of teens. A killing so senseless and brutal, it strikes a nerve across the country.
This nation was shocked.
All the way to the White House.
It was a stark wake-up call to a reality that can be easy for too many to ignore.
A wake-up call to a startling reality, where according to the most recently released CDC figures, on average, 16 young people are murdered each day in the United States. In Chicago, 12 public school students have been killed in the last 4 months, including Darion Albert.
I got some regrets. Like, I wished I would have just stayed home that day.
Vashawn Bullock was one of those kids who took part in the Chicago brawl.
One of the kids had thrown a rock at my brother's car. So I approached the boys like, why y'all throwing rocks and stuff at the car?
Who is this, him on the ground?
That's Darion.
Vashawn says what the public sees in these images and what he saw that day are two different stories. In his world, he says, fighting is about survival.
Tell me though, in the few years you were at Finger, how often were you getting in fights?
Like every 2 weeks, something like that.
Or every couple of weeks, man?
Nah, what you mean by fights? You talking about like fist fights that'll go on like for like the whole day, or are you just talking about just a little altercation here?
Either way, some would say just a little altercation. That's still a fight. And if you get into it every couple of weeks, that's a lot.
But you can only walk away for so long.
No one seemed to walk away that day, that September afternoon when Darion Albert was murdered.
Let me get to this point about Darion. Did you know him beforehand?
Yeah.
From school?
Yeah.
How well did you know him?
I ain't know him like that. All I know is he used to come sit in the back of the lunchroom and come sit with us.
But Darion would also hang out with the kids Vashawn didn't get along with. A simmering tension that would come to a head.
How long can you be friendly if somebody messing with you?
It shocked the nation. But for 17-year-old Vashawn Bullock, this brawl was only a step removed from his everyday reality.
What happened that day that had you end up in the middle of all that?
One of the kids had thrown a rock at my brother's car. So I approached the boys like, why y'all throwing rocks and stuff at the cars?
For weeks, Vashawn says tension was brewing between two rival factions at Chicago's Finger High School. Fights between the teens were nothing new, really, but on this day, some kids came with makeshift weapons.
They brought those weapons to the fight. They picked up them house bricks and brought them. They picked up them bottles and brought them. They ripped the railroad tracks up just to fight.
The video shows a shirtless Vashawn with his brother Eugene Riley standing next to him, both empty-handed, as another teen whacks Vashawn with a wooden plank. When the brothers appear again, they're holding planks.
So your brother comes over and does what?
Swung on one of them with me. He was fighting with me. He had to protect himself and me, because I am his little brother.
You telling me your brother was simply defending himself and defending you at the time with whatever was around and whatever the other side was using?
Come on. I got hit in the back of my head. He got hit in the back of his head with a stick.
Now, did Darion, as far as you know, was he ever part of the group that was jumping you?
I ain't going to say he was fighting me, because I couldn't tell.
So
I,
you assume he was over there trying to swing on you and trying to fight you and your brother?
No, I ain't assuming. I know for a fact.
But authorities have repeatedly said Darion was nothing more than an innocent bystander on his way home from school, caught between two rival groups.
So from what that you see in that video, what do you see your brother doing to Darion?
I see him fighting. He hit him with the stick. It was a fight.
Darion was still on the ground when Vashawn's brother Eugene delivered a final blow.
I know it's your brother and I know you love him, but do you think it was necessary to take it that far?
They brought those weapons to the fight. That's what people not understanding.
But if Darion was down. Why do you think your brother had to go after and hit this kid who clearly wasn't a threat anymore, at least?
Now, he was another body with two hands. That could have been swinging on anybody.
After video of the brawl was released, Vashon's brother Eugene was taken into custody, one of four teens charged in the killing of Darion Albert.
I'm just saying, like, they should let all of them go, because it was just a fight. Fights happen daily.
But, you know, for the police and for our justice system, that ain't good enough. Your brother picked up something and hit a kid, and the kid died.
What about the other people that picked up the weapons and hit me? Where they at?
Don't you think somebody should be held accountable for Darion's death?
Nah, not accountable for the whole thing, because it was a mistake. Ain't nobody wanted him to die. Ain't nobody meant for him to die. It was a fight. Fights get took out of hand. Not intentionally, just because.
And that may sound outrageous to some people to hear a kid died and you hear this kid said he doesn't think anybody should be in jail. But for him, that is his everyday reality. We do this. We see this every single day. I'm a part of this every single day. Just this one fight. Somebody happened to get killed. That is his mentality. That's his logic. That might be hard for other people to understand, but it's hard for us to put ourselves in his world.
Which is why you're calling it a walk in my shoes. But what is the home life like? What do his parents say to him about what you're supposed to do and not supposed to do?
Well, a lot of parents, and we've got more of the series coming up in the next couple of days, but a lot of parents we talk to as well, telling the kids, you got to stand up for yourself. You can't run. You can't walk away. And I've heard this so many times, even from parents, you can't be no punk. Now, that's something that sounds so silly, but you can't be no punk. It's really about some of these kids, the currency they have is not like some kids in suburbs where it's about what jeans you're wearing, what car you drive. Their only currency sometimes is their reputation. That's all they have to fight for, and they will fight for it, and sometimes somebody gets killed over it.
It's a real tragedy. In so many ways.
Yeah, but I got another part coming up tomorrow as well. Going to be looking more into it. And the teenage brain as well. Some doctors say there's a clear explanation for why kids act out like this.